I knew I broke one of the liners in my Stirling engine. I was dusting around. I had one of these heads off of the cylinder and accidentally allowed this to fall down. The body just wiggled a little bit. It was just enough for this connecting rod to come up here and crack this. You can see this crack up through here, and there's a big chunk missing here. So all of these are identical except for this one. And this is the master rod. And it's a little longer and concave, and it locks on this piece so that this remains stationary relative to this cylinder. Then everything works off of that. These are actually a fairly delicate piece of glass. This is ground or honed, and it's a very close tolerance fit inside this liner. And so those should go up and down very freely. And this piece of glass is held in place on this aluminum center section of the piston by a small O-ring. That O-ring is put on the aluminum piston, and then this piece of glass is pushed down over that. And that has to stay dry, and that piece of glass should be level with the top of this aluminum piston. Now, I was fortunate that this broke while I had one of the heads off and I was doing something. And I knew that I had accidentally allowed this piece of glass to slide down inside this part here. And that O-ring got too high on there and it fell down in there, and then one of the connecting rods cracked it. And when these break, this is essentially the same thing as a Pyrex test tube. When these break, they shatter and little bits of glass go everywhere. So I knew I had to take this apart because I had glass down inside here where the magnets were and all over. So I held this up on end and I put alcohol down in there and then blew it out with compressed air a couple of times and got rid of all the little shards of glass that were in the corner like here and down where the magnets are. And up inside these pistons, there were little pieces of glass as well. And they were probably pistons that were down here on the bottom when I broke that liner up here on the top. And the glass goes everywhere. If you have one speck of glass in there and you go ahead and you run it anyway, or maybe just replace this liner and you don't clean it up, those little bits of glass will get flying around. They will come up, get sucked into this displacer and distributed to other cylinders. There's 12 pieces of glass here, and in a matter of seconds, you'll have most of them broken. And this is a photograph of someone who had exactly that happen. So when you take the piston out of here and you blow the glass out of there, and the same thing when you're blowing it around here, be real careful you don't get a piece of that in your eye. This is fairly easy to take apart. These are Phillips head screws. You do not have to take them out. All you have to do is loosen them just a little bit. This outer portion is threaded. And I would support this in a vertical position, put the liner in here, and line up the connecting rod with one of these screws and gently put it together. And then move on to the next one and the next one. I take this O-ring and slide it down on this a little bit so it doesn't fall in there too deep, and have this horizontal so that you're not trying to do a juggling act. What will be listed in a set will be the liner with the inner part that goes on the piston, and that will be in a bubble wrap envelope. Which is rolled up in tape to protect that, and two O-rings. This is the one that goes on the piston, and this is the one that goes on the liner. I put a peanut butter jar in a clamp, and I'm just sitting this on here, so this will hold this level. And I'm going to start putting these pieces in there. And the first part I'm going to put in is going to be the one with the end to be the master cylinder. And hopefully that'll help stabilize this thing here so it doesn't keep spinning around on me. Just carefully slide that in there until you get it lined up with one of those screws. I think I got it. And you want to be careful because nothing is holding this in here. And again, I slide that O-ring up here a little bit too far. I do not want that protruding down here very far. I want the head to come down and gently start compressing that O-ring and sliding that liner down. One thing we think we noticed with one that broke is that one of the heads from the factory was not completely tightened down. That allowed some of that glass to slide around freely. And when it got down here, if that glass slides down here too far, then that connecting rod will come around and it will hit that. The other thing you got to be careful of is as you turn this thing, these magnets are making that jump. Okay, so now I'm going to turn it and I'll get this next one hooked up. After a few minutes, this is back together. And I can turn this assembly now because it's turning with this outside ring. That ring is usually screwed to the base and this can't move. It's the cylinders that move around it. After you put this together and before you go spinning it, you want to very slowly rotate this and make sure that the connecting rod cannot contact that liner here or over here. And by not contact, I mean don't come anywhere near it. If you allow that glass to be a little bit high and the O-ring down on there, the cylinder head will gently push that liner down. That O-ring will find its correct position. And the bottom of the liner, by design, will automatically be well away from the connecting rod. Now the base is back on it, and this thing spins correctly. When I put the hot end back on, I leave all of these tubes disconnected. I mark one cylinder, I connect one tube, spin it, see if I can hear that displacer, take it back off, do the next one, see if I can hear that one working, go around, test all six of them, to verify that all six displacers are clicking back and forth. Now these are all connected, and I can hear all six of them ringing. Fuel it up and give it a test run. See it move a little bit on its own, that's a good sign. When you hear this start to slow down, blow the fire out, let it cool off, and then you can run it again.